Shalom. I'm going to start off by giving all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh. Ba'a Shem Yahweh Shai, Ba'a Shem Rekach Kodash, double honors to the apostles and elders of great millstone who taught me this truth, and salutations to the elect scattered abroad throughout the four corners of the earth. My name is Amon Gabar, back with another quick lesson. Go on to edify and feed the lambs of Yahweh, Ba'a Shem Yahweh Shai, through the Holy Spirit, Rekach Kodash. All right, now, Lord will not make this a quick lesson, straight to the point, regarding a couple comments that I got on previous videos regarding repentance or how to repent. You know, I had a couple people, I'm not sure if it was the same person, but I noticed it was two comments saying make a video on how to repent. You know, so, you know, I just want to say this, that, you know, through the spirit of Yahweh, Ba'a Shem Yahweh Shai, right? All you Israelites, all you new Israelites that are now waking up to the faith, you know, I encourage you, as our apostles and the elders encouraged us to do, is to look up words, all right? Look up words, and you'll see how, you know, how simple things can be once you understand the true definition or etymology of words. And I'm just putting that out there because that's the vibration and spirit that the apostles always threw out there at us. You know what I'm saying? And I'm just putting it out there like that, you know, so don't take it the wrong way. It's just truth. It's facts. You know what I'm saying? Look up words. Look up words. All right. Look up words, because once you look up the word, matter of fact, as this video is rolling, I advise you to pull out a dictionary or go to your phone, smartphone, and go to dictionary and look up the word repent. All right, now what it's going to say is to feel sorry or remorse. All right, to feel sorrowful or remorseful for one's shortcomings. All right, which is for one's sin. All right, because our shortcomings will be our transgressions. All right, so the word repentance or repent means to feel remorseful, to feel sorrowful. So with that being said, you know, nobody can teach you how to feel sorry for yourself, all right? Nobody can teach me how to feel sorry for myself. Now, what we do is we make these videos. We make these lessons. Now, these lessons, by default, should make you feel sorrowful for what you're doing. These lessons are rebuke. They're admonishment. They're chastisement from the Heavenly Father. And by default, it should make you feel remorseful for your sins, for your shortcomings. And that's what Yahweh Ba'a Shem Yahweh Shai is looking for. You know what I'm saying? You know, like King David, right? One of the psalms that the apostles always pushed on us to read back in the day is Psalms 51. All right, and one of the major key points, there's many key points in that. King David said, "Cast me not away from thy presence," which is heavy. That's something we pray for all the time. Another thing he said was, "The sacrifices of sins is a broken spirit, a broken and contrite heart." Now, the word contrite means the same thing as repent. It means, contrite means to feel remorseful, all right? Which is the same thing as repenting. Repenting meaning to feel sorrowful for what you did, for what we do. Because we all sin. We all guilty of going off, you know what I'm saying? And what we need is Yahweh Ba'a Shem Yahweh Shai, all right? Yahweh Shai to come back and save us from this flesh. Else we will be going off forever in all eternity, which that's not going to happen. You know, going back to Yahweh Shai dying on the cross for the sins of Israel, because that's what he did when he went on the cross. All right, he took on the sins of an entire nation of people. All right? You know, he's the mediator between us and the Most High, the one who made that better covenant, as the scripture called it. You know what I'm saying? Which is the law, statute, and commandments being written in our inward parts, you know. So we're not gonna sin in the kingdom. We're not gonna feel. We're not gonna be having to repent because we're not gonna sin. So again, the word repent simply means to feel remorse or feel sorrowful for your sins, you know. And the scriptures say, "Work out your own salvation with fear and trembling." Now you gotta be feeling sorry for your sins and for your transgressions, and genuinely and sincerely feel some type of way about it. That's how you repent. You sincerely and genuinely feel messed up and jacked up for what you did, and what you're doing in return is you ask the Lord to forgive you. All right? Which goes back into praying. Prayers are important. All right? Because prayers is one, it shows that you're faithful, because you're praying, you know, you're praying to like, for example, you're praying, but you know, we can't see Yahweh Bashem Yahushua, but we know that he exists in our spirits, which is a testimony of our faith. We know that he's there. We know that. And we convicted in our spirit that Yahweh Bashem Yahushua, he is, and there's none like him. You know, so what you should be doing is praying. You know, if you're praying, then you asking the Heavenly Father, Lord, please forgive me for what I've done. You know, praying is something we should be doing every day, because we sin all the time, whether, you know, you know it or you don't know it. You know, that's why we got to get out of these bodies. You know what I'm saying? We got to get out of this hellhole, this captivity, because we sin and we don't even know it sometimes. Simple things that are breaking the laws of the Most High, you may not even know it. That's why it's important to pray daily. You know, ask the Heavenly Father to cover you, to protect you. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, back to the question, you know, how to repent, or can you do a video on the new members on how to repent? Repent, again, means to feel sorrowful for your sins, all right? To feel sorry, all right? So I can't teach you how to feel sorry. You got to feel sorry within yourself. You got to feel the your transgressions. You got to feel it and ask the Lord to forgive you and keep it pushing. Like the scriptures say, let not your sins weigh you down. Neither let your wickedness, uplift itself. If I, you know, roughly paraphrase it, somebody can please post that in the description box. Maybe the brothers who asked the question, maybe you could post it. You know what I'm saying? You know, assuming that you're watching this video, you know, so I don't want to talk to, you know, ramble too much, or you know, I ain't got the precepts on deck, but I'm just quoting. You know, and I'm on the road, so, you know, just look up words, man. Look up words. It's important to look up words, and it gives you a better understanding on what you're reading. Look it up in the blue letter, the Greek. Look it up in the dictionary. See what the basic dictionary got to say about it. Look it up on the online etymology. You know, find the exact breakdown on the word, and it gives you a clearer understanding, all right? So, I hope that answers your question or questions. Whoever, you know, may have been seeking this response, you know, I hope that answers you. So I'm going to end it there. Lord willing, this was edifying, straight to the point. Till next time, I say shalom to the elect. Shalom.